plant micropropagation. This is a very cool way of growing plants without soil. Scientists use it to grow plants, whole plants, from just single cells. Or they can use tiny little shoots of plants, which they stick in this stuff here, which is nutrient agar medium. Now, I've already prepared this earlier. You can do it as well. It's very easy to do. All the instructions are on the activity sheet. Now, we'll come back to this later. Second stage of what you've got to do for plant micropropagation is make sure everything is ultra sterile. I cannot stress that enough. Sterility of everything is vitally important. Okay, your second step is to prepare your sterile tank. This is where you do all your propagation work. What I have here is an aquarium, a fish tank, which I've turned on its side. I have covered the whole front opening, or what was the top, with clear plastic, okay? And I've left overlapped the plastic, so there's a bit of a seal there, okay? That will work as effectively, almost effectively, as a fume hood. In here, you do all your propagation work. You have to make sure it is sterile. In here, 80% ethanol. You just to make sure everything is clean and sterile, even on the outside. Give it a squirt, give this bench a squirt, the whole tank a bit of a squirt, give it all a wipe down, the whole bench, everything around you, as much as you can, make sure everything is sterile. On the outside, for a start. Now, inside, even more important. Back on your plastic, on your hands. You'll be doing that a lot today. Rag. Okay, that should be sterile. The next step is to sterilize our equipment. Because did I mention that you need to sterilize everything? The reason for this is because there are fungal spores everywhere. Now, if you're not sterile, you'll grow things really well, but it'll only be fungus. So, okay, get your alcohol. This is my little tool tray. It's a bit of a spray. Dip it out, put it in to your chamber. Now my tools are scalpel and forceps. And in here, I have bleach and distilled water. So what we're gonna do, dip them in the bleach, in the distilled water. Put them on my tray. Same with the scalpel. Be very careful, of course, it's a scalpel. And again, always, wherever possible, keep spraying your hands. You notice I've got gloves now. Next step, preparation of your plant material. Again, very important that everything is sterile. So what we have here, more alcohol. You have your scalpel soaking in a bit of bleach at the moment. I have here cauliflower, which is what we're going to use to grow or to propagate. Here is a solution of detergent and water. That removes, washes the plant, removes any air bubbles that might be getting in between the florets. And this, your final rinse in a solution of 1-in-4 bleach. Okay, cutting blade. Good rinse with bleach. Rinse off with some distilled water. This is where we have to cut our cauliflower. Again, be very careful. And we can put that in our dishwashing detergent. It sits in there getting washed, and then we put it into the bleach solution for another 20 minutes, and that should kill all the fungi. 20 minutes is up, time to get these slippery little suckers. Okay, 20 more minutes in there, and that'll make sure every bit of fungi is dead. This is almost the final part of our experiment. This is where we get to place our cauliflower into the agar medium. But first we have to chop it up into bits small enough to go into the agar. What I have here is the cauliflower, which I took out of the bleach solution in this chamber, and I put them into that little petri dish in there, which has still got a bit of the bleach solution in it. This is my chopping board, which I've got to sterilize. Our friend the alcohol again. Definitely spray some on your hands this time. Spray some on the outside. Cool. Slip that in there. Okay, here's our tools. Find ourselves a little bit of cauliflower, about 2 to 3 mils. Chop that one in half again. That should do us. Forceps into the distilled water. Very important, you probably should rinse them at least 3 times, but for this purpose, we'll just give them a good rinse in a large bowl like this. Good rinse, let them sit in there and rinse for a minute or two. Okay, now we have to get the cauliflower into the agar. And this can be sometimes tricky. Get your cauliflower in your forceps. Now the other trick is to make sure you don't leave the lid off for very long. That lets fungus in. So you've got to do this as quick as you can. Get that lid off very quickly. And as quick as you can, get the cauliflower into the agar and the lid back on again. And you do that for every piece of cauliflower. Lid on, lid off, lid on, lid off. That stops fungus getting into your agar. Get the next piece. Lid off again. Here we go. Lid on. Job's done. That was a big container that you saw. In a class, you're probably only going to use small tubes or small jars like this for your propagation. And there's a very good technique that you can use to ensure that you get the lid off, your plant in, lid back on very quickly. So you have to hold the jar like that, grip it with your fingers, and use your thumb and your forefinger to control the lid. First, get your cauliflower, then your thumb and forefinger, unscrew the lid very quickly into the agar, screw the lid back on. In 4 to 6 weeks, this cauliflower should grow roots, unless I messed up, in which case I'll grow lots of fungus. But this technique is what plant scientists use to help them understand plant biology. They use that knowledge then to help them with things such as developing novel food crops or plant conservation.